A completely passive solar power desalination system developed by researchers at MIT and in China could provide more than 1.5 gallons of fresh drinking water per hour for every square meter of solar collecting area. Such systems could potentially serve off-grid arid coastal areas to provide an efficient low-cost water source. The system uses multiple layers of flat solar evaporators and condensers lined up in a vertical array and topped with transparent aerogel insulation. It is described in a paper appearing in the journal Energy and Environmental Science. The key to the system's efficiency lies in the way it uses each of the multiple stages to desalinate the water. At each stage, heat released by the previous stage is harnessed instead of wasted. In this way, the team's demonstration device can achieve an overall efficiency of 385% in converting the energy of sunlight into the energy of water evaporation. The device is essentially a multi-layer solar still with a set of evaporating and condensing components like those used to distill liquor. It uses flat panels to absorb heat and then transfer that heat to a layer of water so that it begins to evaporate. The vapor then condenses on the next panel. That water gets collected while the heat from the vapor condensation gets passed to the next layer. Whenever vapor condenses on a surface, it releases heat. In typical condenser systems, the heat is simply lost to the environment. But in this multi-layer evaporator, the released heat flows to the next evaporating layer, recycling the solar heat and boosting the overall efficiency. Adding more layers increases the conversion efficiency for producing potable water, but each layer also adds cost and bulk to the system. The team settled on a 10-stage system for their proof-of-concept device, which was tested on an MIT building rooftop. The system delivered pure water that exceeded city drinking water standards at a rate of 5.78 liters per square meter. That is about 1.52 gallons per 11 square feet of solar collecting area. This is more than 2 times as much as the record amount previously produced by any such passive solar power desalination system. Theoretically, with more desalination stages and further optimization, such systems could reach overall efficiency levels as high as 700 or 800%. Unlike some desalination systems, there is no accumulation of salt or concentrated brines to be disposed of. In a free-floating configuration, any salt that accumulates during the day would simply be carried back out at night through the wicking material and back into the seawater. Their demonstration unit was built mostly from inexpensive, readily available materials such as a commercial black solar absorber and paper towels for a capillary wick to carry the water into contact with the solar absorber. The most expensive component of the prototype is a layer of transparent aerogel used as an insulator at the top of the stack. But the team suggests other less expensive insulators could be used as an alternative. The team's key contribution is a framework for understanding how to optimize such multi-stage passive systems, which they call thermally localized multi-stage desalination. The formulas they developed could likely be applied to a variety of materials and device architectures, allowing for further optimization of systems based on different scales of operation or local condition and materials. The researchers plan further experiments to continue to optimize the choice of materials and configurations and to test the durability of the system under realistic conditions. They also will work on translating the design of their lab-scale device into something that would be suitable for use by consumers. The hope is that it could ultimately play a role in alleviating water scarcity in parts of the developing world where reliable electricity is scarce, but seawater and sunlight are abundant. Water scarcity has become an increasingly severe global challenge, as more than 1/3 of the world's population is affected by water shortage. Seawater desalination is regarded as one of the most effective solutions to address water scarcity. In the last decade, commercial large-scale desalination facilities, including the newly built reverse osmosis plants and the legacy installations with multi-stage flash evaporation and the multi-effect distillation, have partly relieved the water shortage stress. However, these technologies require well-developed infrastructure and centralized installations, which are not available in many developing regions. Passive solar desalination systems with a simple configuration and off-grid operation are attractive for several developing regions with abundant solar energy and seawater. But the high cost of water production and large area requirements from low conversion efficiency have limited their adoption thus far. So this invention can boost the usage of passive solar desalination systems.